the magical earth. There's something indeed in the earth of my garden. Is this earth magical? The earth knows how to do magic. If I saw a guava seed, it gives me guavas. If I put in a jamun kernel, it gives me jamuns. A bitter gourd for a bitter gourd, a lemon for a lemon. If I ask for a flower, it gives me pink flowers. Whatever color I give to it, it returns that to me. Has it hidden all these colors in the soil below? I dug a lot, but found nothing. The earth knows how to do magic. The earth knows how to do magic. It shows so many tricks. When it balances these long coconut trees on its fingers, it does not even let them fall. The wind does its best, but the earth does not let them fumble. A sherbet or milk or water, anything may fall. It absorbs them all. How much water does it drink? It gulps down whatever you give. Be it from a jug or a bucket, amazingly, its stomach never fills. I have heard that it can even hide a river inside. The earth knows how to do magic. Are there sugar godowns under the earth or rocks of lime? How does this earth put sweetness into fruits? From where does it get all this? Pomegranates, plums and mangoes. In all of them, sweetness but different kinds. The leaves tasteless, but the fruit sweet. The mosambi sweet, the lemon sour. Undoubtedly, it knows magic. Otherwise, why is the bamboo tasteless and the sugarcane sweet? It knows magic. There is one of the famous saying of Mahatma Gandhi: earths provide enough to satisfy every man's needs, but not every man's greed. Here in the poem, poet has considered greenery of earth as his garden. Poet has asked many questions and also compared many things, but he couldn't able to get his answers. According to him, everything is happening because the earth knows how to do magic, and surely there is something inside it. Here in this poem, poet has used different figures of speech like hypophora, refrain, personification, imagery to make his poem more beautiful with the help of these. We will discuss all these figures of speech in the next upcoming video. Poet says, whenever he sows guava seed in earth, in return he get back so many guavas. And when he puts jamun seed, it gives lots of jamuns back to him. Same way, for bitter gourd, he gets bitter gourd, and in place of lemon seed, he gets lemons. After that, poet says that whenever he asks for flower, in return, earth gives him pink flowers. Poet is surprised that whatever color seeds he sows in earth, it returns that color back to him. He is also amazed that all these colors are hidden somewhere in the soil. For that, one day he dug a lot to find out the colors which earth gives to flowers, but he found nothing. Poet is also astonished that how earth is able to balance long coconut trees on its fingers, even after when storm or fast wind tries their best and trees do not fall down. Poet always has a question in his mind that whenever sherbet, milk or water fall on earth gulps everything and no one is able to find out where it goes. Sometimes he had heard of the story that earth can even hide river inside it. Poet is always in search of answer that are there rocks of lime or sugar godowns under the earth? He is amazed that how does the earth put sweetness to the fruits? He says that different fruits like pomegranates, plums and mangoes, they all are sweet, but still there is different kind of sweetness in them. Though fruits and leaves are on the same tree, but still sweetness is there in the fruits, whereas leaves are tasteless. Though lemon and mosambi resembles to each other, mosambi is sweet, whereas lemon is sour. Same way, poet has also compared bamboo and sugarcane, which looks alike, but still sugarcane is sweet and bamboo is tasteless.